وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما صلوا عليه.
Welcome back. If you've just joined us, we joined in studio today by two very important senior people who have, alhamdulillah, a history of serving the community through SANZF, South African National Zakah Fund, Uncle Abdul Karim Ghani, as well as Uncle Yusuf, fondly known as Tara Sidat, both from the Gauteng region, as well as joined from our Cape Town studios by Maulana Sarfaraz Hassab. Today's topic of discussion has been around the concept of Qurbani or Udhiya. And alhamdulillah, before the break, we saw some visuals of visiting some of the sites where SANZF will be undertaking Qurbani and making sure that all is in order and all is ready for this very important milestone in the Islamic calendar. Maulana Sarfaraz, when it comes to visiting these different sites and physically checking the animals, what are some of the important aspects that need to be monitored and evaluated to ensure that the animals are, in fact, eligible to be slaughtered?
Okay. When we go out, we do, like
Uncle Tara said, we do a few checks at the farms. So, for example, I'm going to draw on just a bit of my experience with SANZF in the Western Cape, just to illustrate this, is when we go out to the farms, we speak with the farm owners, we try to ensure that the farm owners understand the importance of looking after that animal in a way that Islam deems fit to look after that animal, that there's no ill treatment of the animals and so on and so forth. But more specifically, if we were to look at it from a Sharia point of view, then we know, you know, if it's a goat, the goat has to be at least 6 months old. It has to be a year old. If it's a sheep has to be at least 6 months old. So a cow and a buffalo at least has to be about 2 years old. And then if we look at a camel, which we don't really do in South Africa, but that has to be about 5 years old. So those are the first things. You have to look at the age of the animal. Then we look at the health of the animal to ensure that there are no defects with the animal. That the animal is not blind in both eyes or one eye, that the animal is not, limp or limping or crippled in any way, that a third of its ear, nose, or its tail is not missing, that the animal has as both its ears and so on. So we look at the condition of the animal, but then we also look at the surroundings to ensure that the animals are being able to be fed freely, that they're not so congested that would cause them an undue kind of stress. So these are the important things that we need to look at when it comes to the maintenance and the keeping and the preparing of the animals for Qurbani. We know from the hadith of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam the importance of ensuring that the animals are treated kindly and are well kept. And there was a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam encouraged, you know, these in fact in many ahadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam encouraged the treating of the animals well. And there's one where Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala and went to the extent of even scolding and almost lashing someone who refused to give water to an animal before it was slaughtered. So this is from an Islamic point of view, it is important that we understand the rights of the animal and the kindness that the animal needs to be treated with. In fact, I would even go a step further to say that in the Western Cape, and I'm sure in the other regions as well, that the SPCA come out to the places of slaughter where SANZF slaughters on the day of Eid to ensure that all those kinds of things are in place. So alhamdulillah, that is something that is really, really important to us, and it's something we really take seriously when it comes to preparing the animals
The advantage of visiting one of these sites a few days ago with Uncle Yusuf Tara, we did invite the SPCA. Unfortunately, they couldn't make it on that day, which means that alhamdulillah, from our practice, or SANZF's practice of having the SPCA there on the actual day of slaughter, this year we've actually upped it where we've invited them to accompany SANZF on some of the visits that take place prior to the actual day of slaughter, which alhamdulillah is an improvement of the overall process. Manana, Uncle Yusuf also spoke a little bit in his response to me in the first segment with regards to another very important area of readiness and preparedness. That's about knowing who the recipients of the meat from the Udhiyah and Qurbani would be, where they stay, how many people in each household, etc. Tell us a little bit about this from your perspective as an office administrator for a particular region. What does this entail?
Okay, Bismillah, I think again,
Okay, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Again, you know, the kind of preparation that goes into this, you know, SANZAF not being an organization that only operates during Qurbani period, we operate throughout the year, and so the people that are on our files and on our database are people that require help, not only in the time of Qurbani, but the difference that the Qurbani makes to their lives, alhamdulillah, it's phenomenal. You know, you can't always provide people with a big packet of meat every month or whatever the case is. So what happens is that we have caseworkers all over the country that sit and look and interview and assess the situation of those that are in need. Whatever their need is, our caseworkers sit down and they look and they do an assessment of the situation. So when it comes to the time of Qurbani, it is not like only strangers are the recipients of the meat of SANZAF. No, it is people that we know, that have worked with, that are on our projects, that are on our programs, that are trying and that we are trying to develop, and that are trying to develop themselves, that are trying to go out and get jobs, that are trying to make a difference in the community. Those are the people that are also on our Qurbani recipient list. In addition to that, other organizations are also the recipients, because we understand that there's a great need, and many people don't take, you know, what with doing the Qurbani through the South African National Zakat Fund gives us an opportunity to take the entire animal at times, in most cases, and to distribute it. So we have a lot of meat that we share with other organizations as well. So alhamdulillah, in preparing the kind of list or the kind of recipients that would be receiving the meat for Qurbani, that has started well in advance. That is a continuous process and will be a continuous process as time goes on. But more specifically, what we do is, on the day of Eid, we also take Qurbani to the communities. So in some instances where people are unable to do the viewing or unable to visit, you know, where we are doing the Qurbani, then obviously we distribute that on our time on the days that follow afterwards. But there are those that come to our farms or to where we are slaughtering on the day of Eid, or just within the Ayyam al-Tashriq, within the days of Tashriq. And so we ensure that the people that come out also benefit and also get specifically from that meat. So what we do is we've identified certain people in certain communities who are needy based on this the lack of work or whatever the situation is in the family, and this is how we bring the people to the places where SANZAF does Qurbani, and we do a distribution at the places.
Well, it's time for us to take one more short break. We'll be back after this, and then we're going to look at Operation Qurbani 2014. Stay with us.
Salu alayhi wa sallimu taslima hatta tanalu jannatan wa na'ima. Salu alayhi.